别误会，这不是警察的庆生派对，而是记者会结束之后的小小花絮。今天媒体的焦点还是他们。但在提到 YNB 舞弊案件之前，五级安曼商业罪案调查局总监阿马辛先为媒体跟进早前备受关注的跨国电话诈骗案，主要犯案者来自中马两国，但受害者都是中国人。被逮捕的六名大马人当中，其中一人还是拿督斯里，还有一名则是年仅14岁的少年。
Saya merayu kepada orang awam, jangan terpedaya dalam kes-kes sebegini. Jangan sekali-kali memindahkan wang kita kepada akaun orang lain.
看过了警方今天主要汇报后，重头戏来了。配合 YNB 的调查，警方早前透露，在纳吉住处等地一共搜出1670万令吉，但巫统却在警方公开总金额之后入禀高庭，声称那笔钱是属于巫统党产，而实际的数额是1亿6000万令吉，不是警方公布的1亿1670万令吉。此数额的差距被著名布洛克拉惹佩特拉，人称 RPK， 拿来大做文章，指控警方偷钱。究竟这4330万令吉去了哪？阿马辛这么回应
：If RPK has got some credible information with him stating that indeed 43.8 million was stolen at a pavilion, please lodge a report in Malaysia. Don't hide behind the cyber curtain. For the PC on the 25th of May 2018.After we had counted the money, this 114 million was in 26 currencies, and it is the money found at Pavilion residence. Subsequent to that, on the 28th of June, after we had finished counting all our exhibits, i.e. we had finished counting the money, we had finished counting the jewelry, the bags, the watches, everything, and in all the premises, only then I gave my PC. I had mentioned.The total amount is 116 million. Only after we came with the amount, 1 week after that, somebody comes aboard and says, this money belongs to us, and the actual amount is 160 million. But cannot come with a substantiate the basis for this amount.
至于纳吉夫妇什么时候会在针对 YNB 案件陆续口供，阿马辛没有透露确切的日期，只是表示很快会传召。对鲸吞亿万正式将拍成电影，阿马辛幽默的回答逗乐在场所有记者。
I'm about to read the book, yeah. Probably they need to call me to act in the part for the reading. I know you wanted me to say that, probably they need to call me. To, yeah. Thank you.